themselves. And this fire will also will be closing on them. مؤصبة. It's like as if it is like in a vault. Okay, and it looks bigger than that where really they imagine. You see, but it is closing on them the same way they close on themselves by their own worldview. And close it on the society itself. And we are all in the same boat. They are all in the same boat. They will drown together.
This is very interesting. Maybe this is a new skill Dr. Waleed, we can talk already about, but just remind each other. Look at the description as a way to understand what the Quran tried to avoid. So, and we are here in Mecca Quran. When Mecca Quran, the Quran will use a lot of image to introduce ideas and to predict things. So here is very beautiful. كلا لا ينبذلنا في الحطمة. And we say this, he shall most certainly be herded into the crushing disaster. You know, and destroy. But the Quran will come after that. وما أدراك ما الحطمة. It put a question, try to emphasize it. الحطمة and what will make you realize what the crushing disaster is. نار الله الموقدة. It is the fire kindled by Allah. And this is maybe, this is Allah is introduced. You know, Allah is known by all society. Because it's not, it was there before. In Arab also knows the name of Allah. So the Quran is used the common name. See, what to put people together, Arab and Allah also common. So it's the common. It's not just to say, hey, I have different God. You have lesser God. From the beginning, it's used the common things. Because the challenge is how to make people see the world differently together, because we are created for to help each other. But the idea of Quran is predicting here, is telling this way will take us toward a society very divided, you know, and when life itself become hellfire, become very, very difficult. We are going toward the creation of iron cage. Is عليهم closed. عليهم موسدة في عمد ممددة. العمد is extended columns. So it's describing where we are going if we take this direction. So there's ability to predict also, and we try to avoid it because the idea is we are in a trip. We keep moving. So as he's saying, hey, don't take this direction. But the why here is not personal. It's not tribe. It's not has relation with nations. It's really the wrong direction that human being deserve better way and better life than it. And this is very, very interesting here as well. The value right now becomes the new system where you can see and predict the future.
When Naji, I will like end with this, was saying about جَمَعَ مَالًا وَعَدَّدَ, that we accumulate things that to the most of it we don't really even use. Many years ago, my parents were visiting, so I took them like for a drive on Sheridan Road. Very beautiful houses and mansions, I mean, over there. And really, we go from one house to a bigger one, I mean, on the same, really, like, long street. You are familiar with that, I mean, area, I mean, and each house is surrounded by huge, really, like, I mean, backyards, gardens, and everything. And again, I mean, this is the first time even was for me, like, to see these really huge mansions. They look beautiful. And then my father turned to me and said, Waleed, have you noticed that we did not see a single child? It was summer. We did not see a single child playing in these backyards. Which means that these houses are probably empty. And these people have houses all over, probably the world. But again we don't, we accumulate and we do not use. Just like I wanted to share with you that.
I was reading السيرة. But the first one, Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet moved to Al-Madinah, Hijra. So the place where he built his mosque, he let his camel goes to the place was belongs to two orphans. That place he bought it from the orphan, you know, where he built his first mosque. And yeah, the first, you know, this is Islam. You know, the first, you can see the highest thing you can give to people. That the first mosque, you know, the place where you build it. The first one, that place belongs to two orphans. And you know the architecture itself, when they build the mosque, there's two parts. One covered, one open. The open one was for the prayer. The covered part of the mosque, he gave it to the homeless. When you think about it, it's again.
Again, what is the driving force here? Exactly. What is the world view behind it?
This is to what you belong, really. You don't belong to all these palaces. This is really your. You should be proud of it. You need to understand it, and tell it loudly to the whole humanity. And we learn from it, and the other can learn from it. Should not be ashamed to talk about Muhammad in Brasilia or in Japan or China. This is values.
Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was a businessman. Is that right?
Yeah.
Have you heard of him being involved in any transaction? Okay. After he received the message, have you heard of him being part of any big trade? And he had the ability. He is a business person. Unfortunately today, just to see the opposite, we brought to the highest position the 10%. This is how these people portrayed him before he reached that position, and we accepted it. You see what is the difference? What it reflects, what type of, what, where is our state? And this is not our nature. This is the data that needs to be changed. If we accept the status quo, we will, the outcome is really hellfire, suffering, here and in the hereafter. Thank you very much. JazakumAllahu khairan.